One of most common tips for creating photorealistic scene is to use high quality PBR textures, but does it have to be like that? Textures photographed under different lighting can result in no realistic result if the textures don't match well with each other. In this short tutorial, we will create short video using only these two photos. One I took with my mobile phone in collage with concrete texture, plus one free photo from unsplash.com for interior. I will start with a cube with the measures that match the size of a small store by eye. Due to the angle at which the photo was taken, the best unwrapping option is the project from view. I will try to adjust the camera angle similar to the one in the photo. Now I can fix the UV map as best as possible. Adding more geometry will correct the texture, but we will add loop cuts for a reason later. Now I can add loop cuts following the texture and fix UV at the same time. By combining Ctrl-R for loop cuts and E for extrude, I add more and more details, starting from the bigger and more obvious to the smaller ones. This process takes some time. As the base material, I will use the store image for the base color and the concrete texture for the bump and roughness. Since they are both in the same image, we need two UV maps. Now we can use part of the image with concrete without affecting the base color. I will add a part of the concrete texture also to the color input, and for the bump I will use a combination of the concrete texture and the image of the shop. For the glass material, I will use glass and transparent shader. I will also keep part of the shop image in color input and concrete texture for roughness. For the interior, since I don't have much detail in this photo, I found one photo on unsplash.com. If we plug it in the emission and emission strength, we get a light based on the brightness from the photo. With the color ramp, we can control the bright areas, and with the matte node, we can control the intensity. For the mesh look door, I will use a wireframe modifier. I will duplicate the faces and add loop cuts where I want the fence to appear. The wireframe modifier will do the rest. Extruding some random edges, depending on the position of the light, we can create a shadows. Shadows will always make the render more realistic. Glossy concrete texture parts also add a lot of details. You can highlight them if you increase the black parts in the roughness input in combination with light at the low angle. If we isolate the lighter parts of the texture, we can use them as transparent parts if we stick them in the alpha channel. In this way, we can easily add graffiti or dirt from another texture. Although it's the daytime on the picture and the board on the top is not neon sign, I decide to turn on the light and turn it into a neon sign. A neon sign can look more realistic if we add parts that glow less. Noise texture is perfect for that. I will also get the floor from the photo, although it's not a good angle. I can use another texture, but texture taken under different lighting are not easy to fit. The more details from one photo, the easier it is. Since I decide on a daytime scene, I use HDRI. I paid attention that the lights come from the left side because I highlighted that part with a point lamp. For the decoration, I use several models and photo scans that I created before. Finally, I added some color grading and some effects, and this animation turned out. You can unlock the entire 3-hour long tutorial, as well as my other tutorials and project files, by clicking on the Patreon link in the description on YouTube Join.